Hello everyone, I welcome you all in the YouTube channel Civil Engineering. Now today we'll be learning on the topic open spaces. Now what actually open spaces here means? Open spaces here are nothing but front margin, side margin, another side margin and rear margin. The margin which is provided in the front of building, on the side of building and at the rear end of the building is nothing but open spaces. Now why these open spaces are necessary? The main importance of this open space is to provide good lighting and ventilation to the building. If open spaces around the building are not provided, that building will not get sufficient or efficient amount of lighting and ventilation. Second most important thing is, if open spaces are provided in case of any emergency or firefighting operations, firefighter could reach all the corners of building. Hence, these open spaces are most important. Now, what is actually open space? Open space is nothing but the line up to which plinth of the building can extend. Maybe on the front side of the building, side of the building, or at the rear side of the building. And open spaces depends upon the height of the building and abutting road. That is, front margin may depend upon the abutting road, maybe that is village road or district road or state highway or national highway. And depending on the abutting road, front margin, that is front open space, may vary. Now consider this building. Now in this building, stilts are not considered for the height of building. Now what actually stilts means? Stilt is nothing but basement at the ground floor or ground floor which is provided for the parking. This height of the building is not considered during calculation of the total height of building. Now let us see. Open space is useful from the following point of aspects: to meet the lighting and ventilation requirements, as I said earlier, to facilitate the firefighting operations, and to serve the purpose of future widening of street. Now if in case the district road is to be converted into state highway or major district road, then at that time future widening of road is to be done. And this open space can be used for future extension of road so that the constructed building will not get demolished or will not get disturbed. To reduce the noise level and entry of the pollutants in the building by planting the trees. Now in this open spaces we can plant the trees which will provide us shadow. Second, it will reduce the entry of pollutants, and third, it will provide healthy environment and cool breeze in the nearby area. To reduce loss due to fire in case of adjoining building catches the fire. Open spaces for front, rear and side yard depends upon the height of building and can be calculated as width of the open space, that will be in meters, is equal to 3 plus h by 10 divided by 3, where this small h is nothing but height of the building, and it is used when height of the building is less than 25 meters. This formula you can use for the calculation of open spaces. Now this may be front space, side space or rear space. Also you can call it as margin. Now for building having height less than 10 meter, following rules for the front, rear and side yards, that is side margins, are recommended as: front space minimum provided should be 3 meter, that is front margin that will be provided will be minimum 3 meter, and in no case it should be less than 1.8 meter when the building is fronting two or more sides. Now what do you mean by when building is fronting two or more sides? This is nothing but the case when building is at the corner or two roads are approaching our plot. At that time the face of the building is approaching the two roads, and in this case front margin should not be less than 1.8 meters. Second, rear space, that is rear margin, that is margin provided at the back of the building. 3 meter minimum on an average, and in no case it should be less than 1.8 meter. Subject to the condition of free ventilation. Now as we know, for free ventilation, free circulation of emergency services, margins are more important, and minimum in worst case it should not be less than 1.8 meters. And side distance, that is side margin, it should be 3 meter minimum for every semi-detached or detached building. Now you know semi-detached is nothing but a building who is having three margins, one side margin, one rear margin and one front margin. And in case of detached building, it is having margin on all the sides of building, that is two sides margin, one front margin and another rear margin. This is nothing but detached building, and minimum side margin here will be 3 meter. The minimum distance for the construction of any building from the center line of any street should not be less than 7.5 meter. Now this is nothing but distance from the center line of abutting road, that is the plinth of the building from the center line of the abutting road should be at a distance of minimum 7.5 meters. For buildings with height 10 meter and less than 25 meter, minimum space required for the height of 10 meter are increased at the rate of 1 meter for every 3 meter increase in height, or fraction thereof for the height above 10 meters. Now when height of the building is greater than 10 meter but less than 25 meter, the margins will be increased at the rate of 1 meter when height of the building increases by 3 meters. Means our height of the building is 16 meter, then our margin will become 3 plus 1 plus 1, that is 5 meters. And for buildings with the height greater than 25 meter and less than 30 meter, minimum space required for the height of 10 meter are increased at the rate of 1 meter for every 5 meter increase in height, with maximum open space of 16 meter. Means when height of the building is greater than 25 meter but less than 30 meter, then marginal distances will be increased at the rate of 1 meter for every 5 meter increase in height of the building, and maximum space provided here will be 16 meters. Now for educational and institutional building, open spaces around the building should not be less than 6 meter in worst cases. That is, in any circumstances, minimum marginal distances or open spaces provided to around the building should be 6 meters. Now as you can see, educational buildings and institutional buildings are of prime importance, because educational and institutional buildings accommodates maximum public or maximum students. And in case of any emergency or firefighting operations, the 6 meter minimum distance is required so that all the firefighters or emergency services could reach any corner of the building. And for assembly buildings, front space should be 12 meter and other open spaces should not be less than 6 meter. Now assembly building is nothing but large offices, seminar halls, auditoriums, open theater, etc. These are nothing but assembly spaces. And in case of such buildings, such assembly buildings, front margin, that is front space, should not be less than 12 meters in no case, and side margin should not be less than 6 meters. Now why your front margin should not be less than 12 meters? Because this front margin can be utilized for the parking of the vehicles. For business, mercantile and storage building, that is shopping complexes, offices and storage buildings, open spaces should not be less than 4.5 meter in any case. And for industrial building, open space should not be less than 4.5 meters up to the height of 16 meter. Means height of industrial building is up to 16 meter, then in no case open spaces or marginal distances should not be less than 4.5 meters. And if the building height or industrial building height is greater than 16 meters, then open spaces should be increased at the rate of 0.25 meter for every 1 meter increase in height. Means height of the building is 17 meter, then your open space will be 4.5 meter plus 0.25. That is 0.25 meter marginal distances is increased at the rate of every 1 meter increase in height of industrial building. Now next we'll see what is floor area ratio. Now this floor area ratio in another terms is also called as floor space index. Both the terminologies are same. And how you will calculate the floor area ratio or floor space index? It is nothing but the ratio of total built up area upon the plot area. Floor space index is nothing but ratio of total built up area upon plot area. Now consider this plot. This plot is of the dimension 100 feet by 100 feet. Means total area of this plot is 10,000 square feet. Now if we consider that the FSR permissible in this locality is 1, then you see here 50 by 50, 4 stories are constructed. That is nothing but 10,000 square feet total area. Hence, FSI of 1 which is permissible is achieved. In no case when FSI is permissible up to 1 only, then you cannot construct the building greater than the provided or permissible FSI. Second case you may take is 2 stories can be constructed, each story having 5,000 square foot area. Hence, your objective of achieving FSI of 1 will be achieved here. And in another case, a single story of 10,000 square feet can be constructed. Hence, total built up area will be 10,000 square feet and plot area will be 10,000 square feet. Hence, its ratio will give you the FSI of 1. But in practice, this is not the condition because you are supposed to follow the height regulations of the building. You are supposed to maintain the side margin, front margin and rear margin for the buildings. Hence, you cannot construct the entire plot provided this plot is not in Gautam areas. If this plot is in Gautam areas, then you can construct the entire plot without leaving the side margin. But if you are considering the township, then you are supposed to leave the front margin, side margins and rear margin. Depending upon the building may be detached or semi-detached. Now the ratio of total built up area of all the floors to the area of plot on which building is to be constructed is known as FAR or FSI, and it is calculated as ratio of total built up area upon plot area. FSI may vary from place to place. For example, in newly developing areas, FSI will be provided mostly 1, and in Gautam areas or congested areas, it is mostly 1.2. City to city or even place to place in same city. As you can see, in same city or same locality or same town, FSI is 1.2 in Gautam areas, whereas in newly developed areas, FSI provided is 1. Now for calculation of FAR or FSI, there are some deductions which are to be excluded. That is, following areas are to be excluded. Now what are these areas? Projection of the cornice, chajja, roof, shed having projection less than 0.75 meter. That is, all the cantilever projections of the building up to 0.75 meter are to be excluded from calculating the FSI. Second, basement exclusive to be used for parking with maximum clear height of 2.4 meter is to be excluded when FSI is to be calculated. Electric cabin, lift room, ducts, etc., ramps, compound walls, gate, uncovered swimming pools, etc. are to be excluded during calculating the total built up area so as to calculate or determine the FSI. And last, pump house, water tanks, etc. Now what actually is necessity of FSI or FAR? To check and counter density of population. If we do not follow FSI, all the buildings will be constructed irrationally and it will lead to unsustainable developments. Hence, no one will follow the rules and construct the building depending upon their requirement, maybe G plus 3, G plus 4, and may put the life of the people in danger. And if FSI is not followed, haphazard growth of the city will take place, resulting into the unsustainable development, lack of essential services, disturbing the health and hygienic conditions and leading to traffic congestion and pollution. And to control the development activity on the plot of the land, to provide sustainable development and to take care that all the people residing there will get all the facilities like lighting, ventilation, electricity, water supply, drainage system, etc., that is to maintain and control the development of the plot or locality, FSI is necessary. Thank you very much. If you are satisfied with the content, please like and subscribe the channel. And if you have any suggestions, please comment in the comment box. Thank you very much.